Hey guys, how's everyone doing? I'm Anime Intensity. Welcome back to my channel. Happy Halloween! Want some candy? I have so much. Look at this. This is all chocolate and I want to keep it all in my room, but I have the heat on so it's all going to melt. So, bad idea, right? Anyway, today we're actually having my five manga recommendations for Halloween, like horror manga recommendations. I've read a lot of different horror manga and horror manga are definitely one of my favorite things to read, honestly, because I love the genre. I love horror manga, horror movies, horror novels, so I don't know, I just wanted to recommend some manga for you to read for Halloween, you know, something to spook you, you know, something like that, basically. So I have five different titles, well, kind of more than five, but five different titles that I think are really, really cool, and I hope you enjoy the manga that I will be talking about today. If you have your own recommendations for horror manga, feel free to comment below, and we'll just have a little discussion about horror manga. So the first one that I will be recommending today, which is kind of like an umbrella of different manga, is actually manga from Junji Ito. I just felt like getting this out of the way first because he's written so many things, so many iconic horror stories. I was just like, just mention him, bursting, get it out of the way. Junji Ito has created some excellent, excellent manga stories such as Uzumaki, Gyo, and Tomie. Those are all released here in the United States and they're pretty bulky. They're like 3 volumes in one, and they have them like these gorgeous hardcover editions. They're really, really nice. But each story that Junji Ito makes, some of the ideas are a little bit bizarre. Like, take Uzumaki. Uzumaki is a classic, and it's actually one of the most read horror mangas of all time. Uzumaki deals with spirals. And you might think, like, spirals? That's not scary! A spiral? Like, come on! No! Reading Uzumaki will make you afraid of spirals. Like, I never thought that I would be creeped out by a spiral. Yep, Uzumaki did it for me. So, basically, everything turns into a spiral in Uzumaki, and it's just like spiraling into horror. So it's a very, very interesting manga, definitely a must read for horror manga fans, and it's like a classic, honestly. Gyo, or Gyo Tokyo Fish Attack, the OVA thing that they made wasn't too scary, and honestly, the manga isn't too scary, but it's really about fish that come out of water and start terrorizing people. So I don't know about you, but I'm afraid of the ocean and the things that live in it. So that is literally my worst nightmare. But honestly, great story by Junji Ito as well, even though it's a little bizarre, like having a great white shark come out with legs. Very creepy, very bizarre. But I like Junji Ito's work, so it's okay. The next one that will be released soon, I believe this week or next week, I forgot, Tomie. That one is actually about a girl who is very beautiful and she can tell guys to do what she wants, to kill people and blah blah blah, and some even kill her, and basically she can never die. So that's Tomie, and once again another excellent story that Omnibus is coming out very, very soon, about 600 pages or so. So I can't wait to get that one because that's another classic Junji Ito that you want on your bookshelf. But basically anything Junji Ito, something that you want in your collection. Now I know that was like a really broad like umbrella of mangas, like anything by Junji Ito. So now we're going into an actual manga series. So the second one that I will be recommending today is A Drifting Classroom. So I think publication has stopped for A Drifting Classroom, but you can still find the volumes if you look, you know, around, you can still find the volumes. And this one takes place like in a dystopia. So we have like a classroom that gets teleported into a dystopia, and there's a lot of misfortune and silly things happening. And those things that happen in this manga, sometimes, yes, they're silly, but they're creepy at the same time. So it's really funny. Okay, it's not too funny, but okay, yeah, it is. Because you're all school kids and like everything that happens to them is very, very unfortunate, and it's definitely gory and has its moments. It's not too scary, but I recommend it because it's definitely worth it as a horror manga. So definitely check A Drifting Classroom. Number three, another one that I really recommend is Kurosaki Corpse Service, and that one is just excellent. That manga is excellent. There's like 12 volumes out, and basically it's about these 5 college students, and they all have a connection to the dead. So one can talk to the dead, one is good on computers and writes about the dead, you know, one thinks he could talk to aliens and stuff like that. So they all have some kind of connection to the dead, and they basically get dead bodies and they have to analyze these bodies to see like how can they fulfill their last wishes, the person who dies. You know, they try to fulfill those last wishes of those people, and they also try to figure out like how murders occurred or stuff like that. Why did this happen? So it's kind of like a mystery and a horror. It's so excellent, and there are omnibus editions of this manga available, so they have like 3 volumes in one, and it's just so good and definitely a great read for horror manga fans. Number 4, another one that I really recommend is actually Battle Royale. Very, very famous. If you've seen the movie, you know what it's about. Battle Royale is about this class that actually gets like sent to participate in a game on this island, and they have to kill each other, basically. You know, only one person can survive, and they all have to take each other out. They can't escape. If they try to escape, that's no good. They all have to wear a collar that will basically just kill them if they, you know, try to escape or if they do something wrong. So they have to avoid getting killed by their classmates, and then also just because of that collar. So there's a lot of things in Battle Royale. The novel is excellent, the movie is still pretty good, and the manga is amazing, gory, dangerous. You feel that sense of danger, and it's just horror. It's really, really excellent. So if you haven't read Battle Royale or watched it or anything, if you've seen Hunger Games, you will kind of understand what Battle Royale will all be about. But of course, Battle Royale came out way before Hunger Games, just saying, putting that out there. But yes, great story, classic. Last but not least, the 5th and final recommendation for this video that I recommend for horror manga is actually Fort of Apocalypse. Now, Fort of Apocalypse is actually available on Crunchyroll Manga if you would like to read this manga, and it's really, really awesome. So this one involves zombies, so if you like zombies, this is definitely something to read if you haven't already. It focuses around this guy who actually gets sent to a like juvenile detention center, and of course there are other people there. They end up like fighting each other because everyone thinks they're better and whatever, whatever, but then they're zombies. So basically, they're facing each other, but then they have that whole outside world outside of that center which has been taken over by zombies, and it is nuts. It is great. It's a great manga, and like I said, it's available on Crunchyroll Manga. It has a lot of action, a lot of scary moments, a lot of just so many great scenes. I can't praise it enough. So I definitely recommend Fort of Apocalypse. It's definitely a great read. It's a fast read. You're engaged the whole time. So I definitely recommend that manga as well. Sorry this video couldn't have been longer than I would have liked to make it. But if you have your own recommendation for horror manga, please comment below. Tell me which horror manga you really enjoy, because I love horror manga, so maybe I have a read something that you really enjoyed, so I would like to know which horror manga do you really like. So feel free to comment below. Thank you guys so much for watching, totally, totally appreciate it. Please like, share, subscribe if you like this video, and I'll see you guys next time. Raid. I am pretty sure that is not any Captain Earth. That is not Captain Earth. That is not CGI Sidonia no Kishi. No, that's not act.